Hello everybody, and welcome back to Castlevania Lament of Innocence. I've just been quietly bopping along to this music in the background while we were setting up. This is a real club banger for the 11th century. Alright, so, when last we left off, we were exploring the Anti-Soul Mysteries Lab. Is it just me, or does this game have some really fucking metal area names? So we've had the Anti-Soul Mysteries Lab, we've had the House of Sacred Remains, and the Prelude to the Dark Abyss. Now, keep an eye out, because we are still looking out for a false wall. We're looking for a tapestry of a flying two-headed thing, which apparently indicates a false wall. Me just coming through. Also, I have explored the options menu as best I can, and near as I can tell, there is no options, there is no XP system in this game at all. Which is weird, because there's stats. Just doesn't seem to be any way to raise them beyond getting items. So I wonder how you're meant to get stronger in this game. Because we are, you know, 2 and a bit hours in now, and we have not found a new weapon. We found one armor piece, and that's it. And even then, that armor piece doesn't actually give defense, it just Death 5. Weird. My bad. Oh yeah, we did also manage to get an orb, which, upon pondering the orb, changes how all of our sub-weapons work. So the axe previously was like two little things that you'd throw out, but now it's a big old beaver that goes out and comes back. Which I am immediately intrigued by. Very interested to see more of some more orbs. Oh, right. I'm gonna go this way first. Now I'm curious, I'm gonna see what the dagger does. I'm gonna stick with the axe, actually. So I feel like a ranged attack is going to be more useful. Skellymans. See if I can find some holy water, because I don't know what. I don't think we've seen that change into the blue orb. Alright. Doesn't appear to be anything up here. I'm assuming that that big room to the north is going to be our boss fight for this floor, so. I'm gonna save, but I will at least use that to heal. Josh. Break the window. Little rickety ass looking throne room. These men don't look... chewing on me. These men don't look really like they've been hacked. They're all full of nails and crap. It looks more like they've been... stapled. God, he's got it. It's right through his fucking eye as well. Okay, blocking does not help. Stop chewing on me. Fall apart like the old bone dragons. A fixed camera angle is that be very difficult to determine depth. Nice. Bunch of chemical glyphs all over the wall. Don't mind me, you two. I was just leaving. Still not seeing any tapestries. Weird-looking gratings with the orange goo. Block in time. Jump in time. There we go. Toss an enemy into the air by slamming the ground. Okay. Nice! Stop getting back up. To explore as much as possible. Goes up yet higher, alright. What do we got? That makes us some skeleton warriors. Still no tapestries? Bunch of distillery looking things. Really not worth getting into a lot of these fights unless you like really have to. These guys just don't drop much. Yeah. Big Haymaker has a lot of track on it. Not that it matters, because you deed. Yeah, I think I got like, what, 3-4 coins out of that? It's just not worth it. Weird that they would remove the leveling system. Okay, I might be pushing my luck here with the amount of health I've got. Oh! Okay, let's try that one again. Let's try that again. I don't think dodging is less style in Devil May Cry. Yeah, kinda. Okay. I'm going to map. Ta-ta-ta. Where is display mode? Set marker. I'm going to put blue marker there, because I need to come with something that can boost my speed. I need to get a shocky bird. I mean, mine's pretty long right now, but I'm going to be retreating to a safe room. Directly exploration based, like, because there's a whole hub area. Oh boy, there's like a whole hub area and you can pick which ones you do in what order, but that means that like everywhere I've been so far has not been particularly challenging. I don't know. I'm interested to see more, but at the same time, I am very confused. Okay. Yeah, big scary door. We've already seen one of those. Let's... Sorry. Let's finish exploring the upper floor, and then we'll come back and do the boss. Yeah. Like, the combat system is pretty solid so far, but the problem is that, new moves, like new abilities and stuff, seem to be unlocked at like fixed points rather than XP based. Sheer amount of loading. Yeah, it's weird. I've gone through the wrong bloody way. Though thankfully the loading seems to be pretty quick. Bloody tapestry. thankfully the music is absolutely bumping, so... beginning to see why Lament of Innocence is one of the Castlevania games that does not get discussed a whole lot, because I guess, like, when you make something that's as good as Symphony of the Night, you gotta live up to it, you know? When the Scorching Statue is frozen, the Defender will crumble. Okay. We may want to fall back in. Ice crystal then. Notion about where one is. Yeah, there's one just downstairs. How do I reset the death. Emeth means life. Okay. Hang on. What's best? Let's get these in. If I keep finding these, that they are eventually going to all come together, but I'm not getting it, so...
Gum.
Feeling motivated. Hell yeah. Oh, this looks involved. What's this? You've got a busy day ahead of you then. Okay, big observatory that I can't interact with in any way. Hello, switch. Oh boy. I was basically at the top. Just gotta do that a little bit quicker. Ah, you're working on Elleth again, I see. Okay, there's no way for me to reset the timer if I beef it. Take this opportunity to sit up a bit straighter. There we go. That's the spirit. Is that the hardest part? Also, side note, if you're gonna have a timing puzzle like this that requires perfect timing, let me reset the timer. If I screw it up, don't make me wait. But damn it, why do I keep beefing this? I got it perfect the first time. Gonna be the one you keep coming back to, huh? Honestly, that's fair. If you've got a subject matter that you're passionate about, go for it. There we go. There we go. Now, it's weird, like physical distance doesn't matter. It's all about like the height relative to what you're trying to grab. It's really weird and kind of difficult to explain verbally. With an E. Ah, I see. MF means life. Now I just have to find the metal. Ah, well, you see there is that you're being reasonable. Like I said, this is very difficult to explain with words. Hero Leon Belmont just ate dirt. Dracula takes over the world. Okay. Yep, so we want to go back downstairs. I'm going to go and get myself a... the crystal. This knees through his heart. Ow! Duck that landing. Right, so we'll get back down. But it mentioned freezing the scorching statue, so... Yep, so. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, then I've got to take the platform. Don't mind me, guys. You have fun. Unfortunately, all you drop is money for some reason, so there's no reason for me to fight you. Platforms at least have like some magnetism to them, so when you're trying to do weird precise jumps, to get that, this is gonna bother me. I reckon. Oh, hello. Wait, I saw something there. You do actually drop stuff. Alright, who's ready for some depth perplexion? God damn it. I compensated for that. Made it wronger. Yeah, serum, it's weird. Serum cures poison, but so far there hasn't been a single enemy that I've encountered that does poison damage. Mind up. Up. There we go. And. Oh my god! Stuck in this room for a while. It didn't occur to me. Nice. It didn't occur to me, that I was playing a game with two Leons until I actually sat down. So, what's that? Spinning edge, it says. Okay. Right. So that is also a boss door. Okay, there is so much to freaking explore. So if that's the boss door, then what's that one? Okay, either way, still want to get back. Oh yeah, we're gonna square up. I just need to make sure I have the right sub-weapon, because something scorching statue. Save and then go into that big circular room that I've got on the map. I'll check the other door in afterwards. Thank you. through here. Through here. Still no idea where that bloody tapestry is. It's entirely possible it might not even be in this area. It might be in a completely different region. Right. Save you. It's not the boss, because... Oh, this seems good. Oh boy, we're going to be up against the golem. Ah! Meth! The word meth is carved into the wall. Myself. Hang on. Items. I don't have anything. No, it said paralysis, not poison. Okay, be careful when he's doing his big wave attack. Like that.
Scum.
Really? Thankfully I... Damn it! Thankfully I completely beefed my, There we go. Thankfully I came stocked up. Do it. Ah! he goes. Oh. Oh, he's not done yet. Okay. Ow! Focus on his core. Is that gonna... Okay, that still does a substantial amount of damage. Him out. Oh. Orb. Okay, so that is now red orb, which lets me. Okay, that lets me. Plant a landmine. Alright, I'm not going to go that way, because that will just teleport me back to the shop. We still need to figure out what's down that other door then, if there's a secret boss of some flavour. Fix camera back for me. Depth perplexion. Statue. You look intense. Oh, wow. You're no joke. Yeah, the fixed camera like system in Prince of Persia worked for the platforming because it was designed like both the platforming and the camera were designed together. And even then, you weren't expected to do platforming with the fixed camera angle in a hurry. The fixed camera angle was meant to give you a vantage point so you could figure out the broader picture of what you were expected to do. Alright, I am out of magic. Remember that I have a whip, so I have the range advantage here. Down you go! Good heat haze effect. Weapon Whip of Flames. Fire element add. So now. Whip. Nice, now it's black and it's got a little red trail. Okay. Fun stuff. Alright. Let's go back over this way. Give it a quick test. Oh yeah, that is a substantial. That's damn near double my damage. Oh, nice, and my big sweep attack does a flame cascade now. Okay. Doesn't kill the red skeletons any deader, unfortunately, but I'm guessing I need to come back with a divine weapon. Door of that room. Okay, so we have now established that secret bosses are a thing. We may end up needing to go back to the House of Sacred Remains to take another poke around. See if there's anything there that we may have missed. Hey, hey.
Welcome. What would you like?
Do you have anything new? Ooh. Starlight plate magically sealed within. Snazzy. I'll take one.
Is this fine? Would you like anything else?
I'm interested in this.
Anything else? What would you like today? Anything else? What would you like? Something else instead. Is this okay? Okay, I don't mind. Is this okay?
Yes, certainly. There we go, just buy a bunch more of those.
Is that all?
Come back anytime.
Come back anytime. So now, meteor plates. Oh. Why am I not allowed to equip that from the... Oh, whatever. Alright. I'm going to very quickly use the loo, and we'll be right back. Okay. And we're back. Righty dokey. Let's get back into the castle again. Pick where we're going to head next. So we now have the red and blue orbs. So we've done number one and number three, so let's do number two. Let's see where this takes me. Garden forgotten by time. I don't think we ever got to see the garden in Symphony of the Night. Leading these dudes now. Okay, don't have anything on the map. Let's go exploring. Absolutely tabled because I have the flame whip now, which has functionally doubled my damage. certainly in a pertinent way. Yeah, look at that. One whiff, they just get absolutely blown away. Hello. Whip this kinky statue into place. Ah, okay, it's another one of these doors. Still haven't found any other holy relics yet. Kill these guys, their lanterns go flying. Oh, and it does actually do damage. Okay. Watch your step. I'm actually going to try and find more sub-weapons. Here we go, because I've now got the red orb. Let's see what the red orb does to the axe. So, axe, spinning edge with blue orb, spiral axe. Ooh! Big AoE clearer. Stassy. I'm digging this orb system. Oh boy. Platforming. Okay. Leon, what was that? That's handy. What is my HP at right now? 240. Sizable. Pay attention there, there's a bunch of them. Hey there, Father Demon. How you doing? Enjoy your coffee. Okay. I want to hit it while it's up, otherwise I won't have enough height to actually make the jump. Wake and bake. Oh, there was a sprint. They gave me the fly around camera for a reason, and I'm not paying attention. No! Oh, God, I'm so bad at this. This is really simple. It's two buttons. I don't know why I'm struggling. Yeah, this is... No, goddammit. This is a Castlevania game, but it's very odd. There we go. Okay, well, I'm very glad at least that switch doesn't have a timer on it. That'd probably spare otherwise. Hey there, lads. Perish. Oh! One-shot these skeleton archers. Okay. Fable 1 vibes. I never played the Fable games myself. I understand they're well thought of, but never played them myself. No, I'm not joking. I never owned an Xbox. Like, I'm only recently at the point where I can just, like, buy shit for myself. So, you know, only ever had a PS2 and a PS3. So never really had the... never had the opportunity to play a Fable game. But like I say, I understand they're well thought of, but just never had a chance. Oh boy, okay. Okay, I'm gonna go back a little bit and I'm gonna check the other path that was on the room we came in originally. If this keeps going in such a long way. That's the one we came in by. Besides when I get new techniques. Never played a FIFA game. You're not missing much, I'll tell you what. The FIFA games have not been great lately. They've been suffering. Under the weight of bad business practices. But even at their height, they were never particularly good games. Or Need for Speed. I've played Hot Pursuit. I quite liked Hot Pursuit. But I was more a burnout kid during those days. Well, I mean, after everything that EA's done, apparently they've actually lost the license to use the FIFA name, so I'm wondering what's going to happen with... what's going to happen with the... with the series as a whole. It was the whole thing, I don't know if like this was what did it, or if this was like the final straw, or if there was a whole bunch of stuff going across like the background or what. But I understand it had something to do with the Battlefront 2 pride and accomplishment shenanigans. Ah, okay. I need to find... Oh, don't crash. Okay, I need to find the last statue and then come back here. Okay, and then you shall be... Oh, interesting. The marker stones go away if you leave the area. Okay, well, I'll just have to try and remember that that I need to come back to the lab to do that collapsing bridge segment. Yeah, I may be entirely remembering it wrong, but I understand that EA have now lost the license to use the FIFA name, so curious about what's going to happen with that, since the only other competitor was Pro Evo, and Konami don't want to make video games anymore. Get that in writing. This way. Yeah. That's the trick with games like these, always just check the rooms that you haven't been in yet. Playing Blasphemous, people in chat were genuinely getting surprised that I was using the map markers as much as I was, because God, I would forget otherwise. Sandwich have you got there, hey? So just run out from here. Salmon sauce? Classic! I have a chicken and mayo waiting for me once we're finished. interesting on the door. Uh-oh. Gargoyles. That's how you get out of those, is you have to wiggle like crazy. Oh! I have a red hot kick! Alright. Alright, here comes wave two. He tried to, but he got all swooshy. Oh, is this another door that requires a key? I'm guessing a blue key. Blue dragon key, okay. I feel like I should be writing this down. That's fine, this is what the vaults are for. All part of the content, yep. Gemstones from the shop guy are for. Because I can buy them. I don't know why I would want to. Under him. let's see what the dagger can do with the red orb. Okay, it's three in rapid fire. Sure, why not? Into the ground like that, it makes such a weird, like, squish noise. Hurry up and find a safe room. Attrition is always what gets me in Castlevania-like games. In every room I'll go through, I'll take, like, maybe a hit or two. But that stacks up very quickly. Just to be sure nothing's been missed, because you never know with this game. Okay, the red hot kick. Nice cash. The red hot kick does the work against the gargoyles. There must be some sort of XP system with the rate at which I'm unlocking new abilities and stuff. There must be some logic to how they're unlocked. I don't know if it's to do with like how many mandatory encounters you've done. That's how you do it. So jump, jump, kick, kick. Door in that side of the room. Interesting. Let's just in the holy water in a while. Let's see what this does with all these new magic orbs we've been picking up. So, holy water. So, no orb. Blue orb. Red orb. Okay. Let's go with blue orb. So definitely seems to be the get the fuck out of my business weapon. Hey, it's the lizard man. And finally, something that deals poison damage. Juggle combos. Ah. finally found it. Oh, we found... Weird that the last marker stone was way out here. Alright, let's finish exploring around this end of things, and then we'll head back and get that door. Actually, do I have a... Okay, I do have a warp. I do have a warp ticket, so... We will go all the way to the end, and then we'll just warp out, and it'll be quicker to walk back from the inside rather than go through the entire level over again. Definitely said, oh my. And that thing spat out a whole bunch of skulls. Exactly tropical. Lock timings are hard. Poisoned again. There we go. No jumping allowed. Poison ring. It won't let me do it from there, will it? Sometimes prevents poison. Oh, okay. Oh no, wait. Oh. The fact that the fence had fallen down there made me think that there was something there that check out, but it's not going this way yet. These things occasionally laugh at you when you get hit. Another one of these doors. Thunder makes you more resistant to lightning attacks. Alright, well, we'll see if there is any thunder attacks around. Okay, so only one way to go from here. I'm reading that right, aren't I? Yeah. Oh, I see. These guys occasionally just make, like, clanking noises. Hey there, guys. Do you mind if you, like, lined up so I can get my feet once? I wonder who's been teaching this medieval French knight Muay Thai. That's an intimidating door. Some weird statues. Okay. Yeah. Oh! Okay, you can destroy them. Let's commit some arson. I'm sure these are probably imported all the way from Egypt. Nothing in any of them, apart from a door. And a save room. What do you reckon that means, that the boss is just ahead? The teleport to go back and then just come straight back into the garden again to check the other door that we unlocked. Ooh, an actual cutscene. Oh.
Welcome! I haven't had any visitors in a while.
Well, that's fucking terrifying. Oh, no.
With that body, you'll make an excellent statue.
All those stone statues were...
a wonderful sight, weren't they? Don't worry, you'll be joining them soon enough.
Are you the legendary monster that turns people to stone?
Monster? What insolence! I'll grind you to dust!
Oh boy. Medusa head. You were bad enough when you were the size of a basketball. I'm gonna change my ball to red. The fact that she's not, like, emoting at all. There we go, that's how you dodge that one. Quick. Emergency heal. There! Oh god, she's just spewing out snakes. Yeah. close to finishing her off. Probably the wrong one to use, that was my full heal.
Oh well.
Dang it. Nearly dodged all of them. Victory!
That whip is...
It's Ronaldo's whip. Apparently, it's effective even on legendary monsters.
It wasn't so powerful before. Did it gain its complete form?
Complete form?
Still, it's no match for my master!
Oof. Yeah. Why is that giving me the heebie-jeebies so much? Purple orb. Or plorb, if you will. Alright. Since we're right here, what does that do? Cross blazer. Nice. Okay. Yeah, we've checked basically everything around here, apart from we need a key. Alright, use that to teleport back, and then we'll just come straight back in to after doing some stocking up, and then we'll come straight back in to
check that secret door.
Hey, Arva. Oh, welcome.
Ronaldo.
I'm glad you're back. What's the matter? You have an odd look on your face.
Well...
It's these polygons. They don't
about
quite
this whip,
stretch like
were
they're
there
supposed
problems
to.
With it?
No, that isn't it. I heard something about it gaining its complete form.
Oh, that. That's true. The whip is not yet complete.
But it has become more powerful than before.
That is because of you. I hate to say it, but it seems it fits you better than me.
Is there a way to complete it?
It's better for you not to think about that. It's impossible by any normal means.
But...
Do not think about it. There are other things you must take care of right now.
All right.
Do not go and defeat all of the secret bosses to gain its complete form.
Welcome back. What would you like today? Something else instead.
Okay, you know, I'm gonna...
Is this okay? Would you like anything else?
I'm gonna buy some of these gemstones.
Okay, anything else? What
just
would you like today?
Because I'm curious about what the hell they end up doing.
Anything else?
Good luck.
Alright, so we're gonna go back to the garden, get that secret door, and then that'll probably, depending on how long it takes to explore what's on the other side of that, that might be us done for the day. Still haven't found a single other relic yet. I'm still... very confused by that, considering there's supposed to be, like, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. and we've defeated three of them, the major bosses, and haven't found one other than the one that he gives you for free. Save while we're here. So I can only assume, considering that Leon is supposed to be the first Belmont, is that this whip, when it becomes, when it gains its complete form, it becomes the Vampire King. That's all I can assume. Straight back in over here. God, I forgot my time. It says cleared, but we're not quite clear yet. There's still a bunch of secrets we need to find. Turning it off and on again and screwed it up. Well, I remember where the thing was. So I can only assume that the rest of this place is going to be behind the blue door. Well, I was hoping for more exploration to do, but womp womp. Let's go back and we'll at least get started on a new area then. Stretch my neck out. So. Cleared. What does number 4 have in store for us? Dark Palace of Waterfall. And these fucking area names. Weirdly, like, metal, considering Symphony of the Night was just like, you know, Marble Gallery, Alchemy Lab, Ruined Entrance. Jump into the water channel. Alright. This way. Let's try and find a save room. Uh-oh. Lizard boys. Fish man. Okay. Should have guessed by the music. During vertical high, an upward attack during jump. I now need to remind myself what the high time attack was. Square, 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 triangle. Oh, okay, and then that lets me follow them up. assuming that they don't bounce off the roof and just come crashing straight back down again. Oh wow, that just deletes those guys. Okay. And bonk. Where is this leading me? Just picking a direction until we hit a dead end and then. Spamming AoE blasts. I think the holy mortar might be quite powerful. What does purple axe do, I wonder? Oh yes! Whirlwind of steel. The bridge in the room with a large book. Okay. And there's a effigy of a skeleton approaching an archway. Okay, I'm guessing there must be a door back there now. Still need to find a save room. It's fine. If all else fails, I will just do a save state. What is a man? Miserable little pile of secrets. Yeah. Oh yes. just fabulous now, it's a blender. Hey, and that's a safe point. Okay, let's get to that save room so I can wrap up, because I've got a sandwich calling my name. It's quite unsettling, I should really check on what it's up to. Go. Alright. Bonk. And that will be all. So, let's head on over to the booth, and we will see if anyone's on that we can go and raid. Don't leave it there, so we've got good music. So, Twitch. Who's about? Well, that's handy. Colonel's just gotten started playing some Pokemon Infinite Fusion. Let's go. Boom. Let's go on over there and say hey to, what was it, Glorious Leader? Was that... I love the way he names his Pokemon. It's great. Anywho, until next time, thank you all for joining me. I'll see you tomorrow. Good night.